I came to Moss Rehab from another hospital after having my leg amputated due to an accident at my employer. It got hit by a roll of steel, rolled off a forklift, and was 30,000 pounds. At that point, they tried to save the leg, pinned it back together, but they couldn't. There wasn't enough veins to carry the blood in the leg, so it was better to amputate it than try to go through years and years of rehab just trying to get the leg back together. I thought my life was going to be confined to a wheelchair. I really didn't think maybe a walker, best case scenario. That was it. Life was over. Everything you knew. I enjoy swimming, traveling. I figured all that was done, but I was still alive. As you're sitting on the mat in that gymnasium, that you would never, I'm never going to walk. I'm never going to be there. But it was, I'd say, a matter of 3 months. And they had me up and walking, which was, you know, a miracle in my book.
I think his biggest challenge was just realizing that, you know, he really can go back to that life that he lived before. The realization and the thought that, okay, you know, this doesn't have to hold me back, and I don't have to be dictated by this this injury and this loss.
I used to come in with a cane quite often, and they would always yell at me when they would see me with the cane. You know, what are you doing, Mr. Wolf? Well, you know, it's like my safety device, that. And they would take it away, push it away from you. Yeah, you're not supposed to do that, you know, and just push you and push you and push you and keep going.
Even if he was a little unsure about, you know, the activities for the day and his ability to achieve them, he was ready to work with the therapist and really work towards those goals and the trust in the therapy team. He's had really great interaction with the physicians, the therapist, and our entire team here at Moss. I know we've really enjoyed having James here, and I think James could say the same about really enjoying coming to therapy. And I think at the end of the therapy process, you really look back and, you know, it's a friendship too. You spend a lot of time with each other, and there's a lot of hurdles that are cleared with each other, and you develop a friendship and understanding, and, you know, we love hearing from him.
I won't park my car in a handicapped spot because I'm able to walk. I think that's more should be towards, you know, somebody that really needs that. No, I don't consider myself disabled. I consider myself very lucky at 57, after surviving what I did, to be able to walk and maintain a normal life.